ವೈದೇಹಿ ಸಹಿತಂ ಸುರದ್ರುಮತಲೆ ಹೈಮೇ ಮಹಾಮಂಡಪೇ ಮಧ್ಯೆ ಪುಷ್ಪಕಮಾಸನೆ ಮಣಿಮಯೇ ವೀರಾಸನೆ ಸುಸ್ಥಿತಂ ಅಗ್ರೇ ವಾಚಯತಿ ಪ್ರಭಂಜನ ಸುತೇ ತತ್ವಂ ಮುನಿಭ್ಯ ಪರಂ ವ್ಯಾಖ್ಯಾಂತಂ ಭರತಾದಿಭಿ ಪರಿವೃತಂ ರಾಮಂ ಭಜೇ ಶ್ಯಾಮಲಂ ನಮೋಸ್ತು ರಾಮಾಯ ಸಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಣಾಯ ದೇವ್ಯೈ ಚ ತಸ್ಯೈ ಜನಕಾತ್ಮಜಾಯೈ ನಮೋಸ್ತು ರುದ್ರೇಂದ್ರ ಯಮಾನಿಲೇಭ್ಯಃ ನಮೋಸ್ತು ಚಂದ್ರಾರ್ಕ ಮರುದ್ಗಣೇಭ್ಯಃ ಹರಿಹಿ ಓಂ. So we are in a very, very important stage in the entire Ramayanam. We are in a very important stage in Ayodhyakanda. It's the most important part. See, this is called Ramayanam, Ramasya Ayanam, the path that Rama has taken. Today we are going to see that very powerfully. That is why it is called Ramayanam. And if you remember in the last class, up to the last class, we saw how Kaikeyi cornered Dasharatha, how Dasharatha has been lamenting for all the mistakes that he did in life, which landed him in such a trouble. And what we saw at the end of the class is, last class, is on behalf of Dasharatha, Kaikeyi gives instruction to Sumantara, in English Sumantara looks like a long vowel, Sumantara, it's a short vowel in some ways, to go and bring Rama. So that is where we stopped last class. And today is a very, very important part of Ramayana. ರಾಮಸ್ಯ ಅಯನಸ್ಯ ಉತ್ತಮ ದರ್ಶನಂ ಅದ್ಯ ವಯಂ ಪಶ್ಯಾಮಃ. ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ರಾಮಾಯಣ. ದಿಸ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ನೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ರಾಮ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಶೋನ್ ಇನ್ ಫುಲ್ ಮೆಷರ್ ಟುಡೇ, ವಿಚ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಸಚ್ ಅ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಟು ರೀಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ರಾಮಾಯಣ. ಐ ರಿಯಲಿ ಎಂಜಾಯ್ಡ್ ರೀಡಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್. ಸೊ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಶೇರ್ ದೋಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಯು ಟುಡೇ. See, the point was, when I read all that and when I prepared the slides, there was one thing which was very clear in my mind. See, there are lots of people who will say, no, I am more, I have now become better. I have controlled myself these days. I am okay. Or, we even know thoroughly what are the attributes of being a good person. All that we'll memorize, we'll be able to tell you off the memory. I can quote you shlokas, all that I have seen people. But the proof of the pudding is in eating. See, when good things happen, your character is never known. Because good things can be generally, it is easy to handle good things. All the assumptions about an individual, saying, no, I have overcome anger, I have developed patience. People say so many things. They are not to be tested when everything is going well. The real test of a character, real test of a vyakti, is when something extraordinarily adversarial happening. That is where we are going to be today. So this is the time we will know who is Rama. That is why this is a very special part of Ramayanam. In fact, this is why I like Ayodhyakandam. This is why I say everybody, particularly youngsters, must read Ayodhyakanda. It paints life so well. It says that this is what life is. If you think life is all good and everything good will happen, we are very, very have an artificial understanding of life. That is the greatness of Ayodhyakanda. And we have stepped into that part of the story. So we will see. In fact, you have to read other shlokas. I am, you know, sort of skipping those shlokas. The gravity of the situation you can grasp it only when you read the other shlokas. When Rama steps out, when Sumantra steps out of Dasharatha's palace, en route is Rama's palace. What a description of how the whole city was rejoicing and preparing. What happened in Rama's palace? I am skipping all those shlokas. You know, for want of time, I'm, you know, sort of making a selection. But if you read those shlokas and then see these, your understanding of this issue that we are talking will become orders of magnitude. Because, you know, that is the situation. But we will still go through it. So, 15th Sargam of Ayodhyakanda. 49 shlokas are there. And the first 15 shlokas are the elaborate arrangements that have been already made for the Pattabhisheka. So much so that in those shlokas you will find that it is not only the description of all these ritviks are all there, water from so many Ganga, Jamuna, confluence of rivers from all four directions, from the seas, from this river, that river, big rivers, small rivers, you know, then how there is this royal horse and elephant standing. If you read, you understand the gravity of the situation that we are talking. And in between, the shlokas also say, it's all going to be sunrise. Where is the king? We are all ready. The king has not yet come. So that kind of shlokas are also there within these 15 shlokas. So they are all saying, I know the king should have come, and it's Pushi Nakshatra has come, has ascended onto the Palguna and all that. So where is the king? So they are all wondering who should go and fetch the king. All those bit of one or two shlokas are there. And then Sumantra says, because Sumantra is such a close, this thing of Dasharatha, and he has that much respect of all the king and the princess and all that. So he said, let me go. Let me go. And then so that shloka 16 to 27 is, a little bit of that was told in the last sarga. It is played out with a little more detail here. Because last sarga we saw Kaikeyi said, go and bring Rama. But here there is a slight, playback, little bit wound back. So again, the description, the price of Dasharatha, Sumantra goes in and then, does his prayer for Dasharatha. You are the greatest king of Raghuvamsha and all that. Uttishta, Uttishta sort of things. Then Dasharatha, 26 shloka, we'll see. Dasharatha says, Kaikeyi has already asked you to bring Rama. Why are you not? He's showing his restlessness by a bit of anger. See, when we, that's why Krishna, Arjuna has Atakena Prayuktoyam Papam Charati Purushaha Anichanapi Varshne Baladiva Nihojita. This is what happens to everyone. When they get tense, they shout at people. Sumantra need not be shouted at. But then Dasharatha, it's an expression of some pain that he is going through, the disappointment. He is trapped. So he is downloading his emotions on Sumantra. So why have you not gone? Don't you listen to my advice? Some such shloka is there. So I am reminded of that shloka in Bhagavad Gita. Atakena prayuktoyam papam charati purushaha. Anichanapi vashneya baladiva niyojitaha. That's what would have happened to Dasharatha also a little later. Anyway, those shlokas are there. And then the shlokas 28 to 42 is a beautiful description of not only the city. As Sumantra goes from Dasharatha's palace, as Sumantra goes into the city of streets of Ayodhya, so many descriptions of how it's all prepared. Then when he enters into Rama's palace, there is a beautiful description of Rama's palace also. It all is showing the air of expectation. Everybody knows that Rama is going to be the king. That Valmiki brings so beautifully through those shlokas. It is only saying how serious is the problem. It is only showing the problem is quite serious. Don't take it light. It's quite a serious problem. So all those are there that he saw. Rama's palace is described. There are thousands of people waiting there. There is a royal elephant and a horse waiting there. There is a golden something something waiting there. All that. There's a white umbrella. So many things are being described. Only to say that everybody is all expecting the event to happen. And Sumantra enters into Rama's palace and people are ready. So many arrangements are being, he sees all of them. So those are all described in this particular sarga. We'll see a couple of three, four shlokas from this sarga to get a sense of what it is.
Ramam anaya suteti yadasya bihitonaya kimidam karanam yena mamagnya pratihanyate.
Dasharatha is shouting at Sumantra in this shloka. What is he saying? Ramam anaya. Bring Rama. Right? Suta. Hey, charioteer, bring Rama. Iti, right? Abhihitaha anaya. Yet abhihitasya anaya. So, she told. Kaikeyi told, go and bring. That's the first line. Then the second line, kimidam karanam. Yena mama agnya pratihanyate. You are not taking my order. He didn't order. He's showing his anger is being downloaded now on him because he didn't speak. It is only Kaikeyi who spoke actually. So, but what is he saying? Kimidam karanam mama agnya pratihanyate yena.
By your act of not doing this, you are still standing here. Kaikeyi told you, go and bring Rama. You are still standing here. So by this very act, you are not taking my order. So it shows his desperateness. It so shows his restlessness. He is going through a great problem. There are some shlokas which I didn't bring. If you read, you will find what struggle Dasharatha is going through. I did not bring those shlokas. I merely said those and you will see all that in this sarga, in these sargas.
Nachaiva samprasuptoham anayeha shuragavam iti raja dasharatah sutam tatran vashat punaha.
Nachaiva samprasuptah. I haven't slept well. Whole night. Nobody knows the reason except Kaikeyi. But the fact is Dasharatha hasn't slept. So he tells to Sumantra, I haven't slept. Sumantra understands it as an anxiety because that's what Kaikeyi also feeded that idea. He said, oh, because Sumantra asked, why is his eyes like this? No, the joy of Rama and all that, whole night he hasn't slept as though he is waiting for that to happen. Kaikeyi gave that kind of an impression. But then here Dasharatha says, Nachayeva samprasuptaha aham. Anaye hashu. Immediately you bring him. Raghavam anaya. Immediately, jatiti. You bring him immediately. Right? Iti, thus, Raja Dasharataha, Sutam, Tatra, at that time, Tatra is also used sometime for the time also, although strictly Tatra means there. In that situation, you can take it like that. Tatra, Anvashat Punaha, Punaha Anvashat, he ordered him again. He said, Koko, please bring him. He also is going through this problem. He is also, he doesn't know what is going to happen. So he is very restless. His shlokas are all showing his huge restlessness that he saw. This is nearly the last shloka in this chapter. After Sumantara enters into, as he is entering to Rama's palace, what did he see? That is what this is saying. It says,
Upasthite ranjali karakaischa sopayanair janapatair janaischa kotya parardaischa vimuktayanaihi samakulam dwarapatam dadarsha.
Dwarapatam dadarsha. That path which leads to the gate. There he saw. Dadarsha he saw. Where? Dwarapatam. Near the gate, in the gate. All that you can take as description of that. What did he see? Sumantara. Upasthitaihi. There are so many people were there. How many were there? Kotyaha parardascha. Parardha is actually 10 power 17. Dilavati is a great
treatise on mathematics. Leelavati, Paskaracharya's Leelavati, his daughter's name, he wrote it. In that first chapter, at the beginning, there are these Ganapati Vandana, there are one or two slogans. You know what then immediately does? Because it is a book on mathematics, no? So what he did was, in the first chapter, he enumerated first the number system. So that is one sloka. Eka, the sloka goes like this. Eka, dasha, shata, sahasra, ayuta, laksha, koti, adbutam, karva, makar, karva, nikarva, maha, padma, anti, like this it goes up to parardha. There are 17 terms. I'll not remember that sloka. Sometimes when I utter it comes in a rag. goes up to parardha. Karva, nikarva, padma, maha, jalati, antya, like that. There are different terms are there. Goes up to parardha. Then it says, krama dashagunottaram samjnaha purvaihi kritam. This is 1st century BC. He says, I am not telling this. Purvaihi kritam dashagunottaram. The decimal place value of number is the greatest contribution of India. 10 power 17. There is a number 10 power 141 in a few places. Gautama Buddha's Swayamvara. There is a book called Lalita Vistarana. In that it is there. Gautama Buddha's Swayamvara was a quiz on mathematics. Many would not have passed perhaps. He was asked a number. That number was 10 power 53, Tallakshana. 10 power 57 or 53, I think. 10 power 53, I think. Tallakshana. Then when Gautama actually replied to a sage called Arjuna, Arjuna is conducting the test, cat kind of test perhaps. So when he replied, he said, sir, I will tell you the number you asked, which is called Tallakshana. But he said, we have a system of counting. It says 10 power 2 power some 23 plus 1 times n, there is one formula. He says, use this formula. You put n equal to 0, you get 10 power 53, the number you asked. If you put n equal to 1, he says there are 9 levels. 0 to 8, 9 levels. If you put n equal to 0, you'll get 53, the number you asked. Then it will go in steps of 46. The next number is called Dvijagravati, 10 power 99. So he goes up to 10 power 421. So Indians had such large numbers with them. So Parardha is actually 10 power 17. So Kotyaha Parardhascha Janaha. How are they? Anjali Karakaischa. Some of them were like this with Anjali Mudra. Their hands are folded like this. That's Anjali Mudra. Many are standing like this. Anjali Karakaischa. Upayena Saha. Sopayanaha. Some gift in their hand. Upayana is a gift, something to give. So, sopayanaihi janapadair janaihi. People from all over the janapada, villagers, that they showed their love. They want to show their love for Rama. Rama is a celebrated personality for them. And he is going to be, you know, coronated as the next Yuvaraja. So janapadehi janaihi parardaicha with upayana. Okay? Then vimukta yanehi raratas. So many, which means they have all traveled. We don't have Volkswagen and all that. We have only Oxford, as in showed in Gandhi movie, you know, Oxford, something like that. So they had some 10 hours for, 4 hours for, whatever. So all those, so many of them, they all come in the ratas. Samakulam, they all akulam, well surrounded and all collected in some ways. In other words, this shows that the decision of Kaikeyi is going to be against the grain of any contemporary acceptance. And that is what Valmiki is bringing here. The descriptions are only saying she is going against the grain of the very reality. That's the height of foolishness. Yet, we saw Kaikeyi's character last time. That's why she is doing. Mana eva manushyanam karanam bandha moksha yoga. Like that. Arena uddaret atmanam na atmanam avasadet. Atmaiva Bandhu Atmanam. That is the problem she is going through. She is going against the very grain of common sense, reality, and the popular Janapada expectation, which is unrealistic, but that is what it is. So Valmiki has so many shlokas to bring that concept and that idea that she is going against the very grain of what it ought to be. That's why these shlokas are coming. Sixteenth sarga, 48 verses. So Sumantra, the previous sarga, he described who are all waiting at the gate. So now he enters in into the, you know, Rama's palace, and so he again saw so many people are waiting there, very happily talking about how Rama is going to very soon, you know, become the Yuvaraja and those kinds of things. Then Sumantra and I'll show you some 3-4 shlokas. Rama's mood. Rama and Sita were just at the brim of their happiness because they are going to be the Yuvaraja and Yuvarani. That feeling, this is the greatness of Ramayana. Ramayana, Valmiki presented Rama as a human being with full emotions. Yet, he was a human being par excellence. You can have emotions in life. The message that we have to take is, you can have emotions in life, but you cannot afford to be emotional. There's a difference between these two. Emotions, you know, again, this famous story I have told a few times, I'll tell that story now, because at this point I must tell, remind the story again, that the Shishya and the Guru, and the Shishya, you know, passed from the Gurukula. Very bright student, he passed out of the Gurukula, and then he married a beautiful girl, and then they were living. Very soon the girl died. So this boy was in complete grief. So the guru got to know, very nice boy, he's very favorite student, bright student, very respected student, he'll be very respectful of the guru, all that. He goes and sees the Shishya, and Shishya is in great grief. So he goes and tells him, you know, life is all like, he talks a lot of philosophy to him. Death will come and go and all that. This boy, after some time, he said, stop it. My wife is died and you are telling all these things like this. So the guru gently withdrew and went away. But Atakkena Parayugdoyam came into the to the boy the next day. He said, why did I do this? I should not have done this. I have a lot of respect for my guru. Why did I do? So this thought was really affecting him. So after 2-3 months, he cannot stand. One day he went to the guru. He went and met the guru, and then the guru smiled at him and said, please come. Then this boy said, I have come here to ask for my pardon. He said, why? What happened? No, the other day, 2 months back, you came. I was very disrespectful to you and all that. Guru said, no, I don't remember any of those. But I remember one thing. That day when I came, you were crying like mad. Can you do me a favor? Boy said, sir, I will do anything for you. Sit in the corner and then cry like that for 1 hour. This boy could not cry. The boy could not cry that day. If somebody was crying for months and months, they are emotional. They will become a nervous wreck. So we can't be emotional. We should have emotion. Of course, the boy may still love that girl, and that girl will be living in his heart. That's a different story. But Prakriti has wired us to face the reality and keep going. So Rama shows that time and again in Ayodhyakanda. Of course he has emotion. You just see how he is going to pour his emotion. You just wait. You just see how he is going to pour his emotion. He'll pour his emotion like any human being. But then in no time he rises to the highest level of the perfection that a human being can ever aspire for. That is a lesson. You can't take that emotion and put it into your head and then spoil you and others. And that means you are Sada Sida character. That's why we have to read Rama. So we will see shloka as well. Rama, how much of hope has built into Rama, we will see. In shloka 19, 16, 17, 18, 19, we will see. All those are there. And then Rama says, because Rama, it's a surprise for Rama. Rama tells you, we'll see the shloka. It will be very good to see the shloka. Say, wait, I will come. I think there's something father is calling. Let me go and come. So he goes, he leaves the palace. Again, as he goes on the streets of Ayodhya, what did he see? How thousands and thousands of people were standing, ladies were standing on the rooftop and blessing with flowers and this and that. They were all talking very high of the qualities of Ram. Valmiki has showered that shlokas, actually. All those are there till the end of the sarga. But I am going to take only 4 shlokas because that you can read. That only will make the case even stronger for us to look at. When Sumantara came and told Rama, Dashrada wants to see you immediately, please come. When he said that, this is what Rama is saying now. Immediately Sita is around, he is telling to Sita. What is he saying? Devi. Devi is the Sambodhana for Sita. Hey Sita, I will tell you what is happening, right? Devascha Devi cha. The second Devi is Kaikeyi. The first Devi is the Sambodhana for Sita. That's why it is in Rasva, that is in Dirga. Devi, Devi. Sambodhana. Okay? Devascha Devi cha. That is Dasharatha and Kaikeyi. Devi, Devi, Devascha Devi cha. Samagamya madantare. Mantre ete drivam kinchite. Yadabhishechana samhitam. She's telling Sita, you see, Kaikeyi and father are discussing something very important about our Abhishechana. He says, Devascha Devi cha samagamya, they have come together, madantare, and discussing about my case. That was fact. The situation was different, but it was true. Satyameva. Madantare. Mantriyete. 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 They are doing some contemplation, thinking, right? Dhruvam, I know for sure. There is some discussion going on about our kimartam. Kinchit abhishechana samhitam. It's all about some nitty-gritty details, perhaps. Some last minute, something to be clarified. Some finer discussion Kaikeyi and Dasharatha are doing. This is the, so he see the mood of Rama now. Rama is all set. In another half an hour, things are going to happen. So he has developed that high hopes with the way he is saying Sita. Then you look at the next. Lakshayitva hyabhiprayam priyakama sudakshina sanchodayati rajanam madartam asitekshana. Priyakama sudakshina. These are all adjectives for Kaikeyi. Right? Kaikeyi is mama priyakama. This is what Rama is saying. She is interested in my welfare. So Rama is saying, no. So Priyakama is actually coming from there. Priyam Kama, Mama Priyam Kama Iti Sa. That's why she is Priyakama. So Bahurihi, you know, like that. So Priyakama Sudakshina with a, she is well, Sudakshina, she is a well-wisher of the king. The right eye is on her, actually. So which means that she is the, favor of the king. Okay, Sudakshina Priyakama Sanchodayati Rajanam. Okay, Matartam. And what for? For me, she is saying something. All of them are true. What she said was only different. Valmiki has used words so beautifully, none of them are wrong. All that was true, actually. Right? Right? Abhiprayam Lakshayitva. Right? Knowing his abhiprayam lakshayitva, he also knows all of them are true. She knows her abhipraya, and then you can take the shloka whichever way you want. But Rama, from Rama's perspective, he doesn't know all these bad things. So we have to interpret it only in a positive way now. Same shloka, 5 sargas later, we can interpret it differently. Up till now, Rama doesn't know. So beautifully Valmiki has used this shloka. He says, knowing what the king has in his mind, she is a favorite, and she is, Asitekshana is the dark eyed. Asitekshana. Asitekshana. So she is, all these are, So Rama is saying, no, they are all discussing something very important. There are some small little issues that they are trying to sort it out. And for that, I think probably Sumantara has been sent here. Next 2 shlokas make it even clearer.
yadrishi parishat tatra tadrisho duta agatah driva madhyeva mam raja yavaraje bishekshyati.
The parishat is so big. See, if it is a very important thing, you send a person of a higher order. It's a small little thing, you call a boy and give a chit and say, go and give it. If it is something very important, you send the manager. Or you send your, you know, if it's very important, you send the general manager. Or your director. Executive director will go. Right? So that's what Rama is saying. Yadrishi parishat tatra, the situation there, again this is true. It has double meaning, so to speak. But Rama is seeing it from a very positive sense now. He doesn't know what is going unfold. See, Adrishi Parishat Tatra, Tadrishaha Dutaha Agataha. Sumantra is not an ordinary man. If he has been personally scoured, sent to me, asked me to bring, right, Dhruvam, no doubt. Today itself, Abhisheka is going to happen. His hope has gone to that level. Rama is a human being, please understand. But he is a Maryada Purusha. He is a human being par excellence. So he will have, you know, you will see in 53rd Sarga, 19th Sarga, he has been asked to go. 53rd Sarga, he will cry. I will show you how much Rama is crying. Valmiki has portrayed emotions of Rama and said, if only Valmiki said Rama is a god, he would have actually trashed Ramayana, because God can do here, what can I do? He portrayed him as a human being. He said, live like him. Have your emotions. If Valmiki has said Rama is a god, then there is no value for Ramayanam, because we will simply dismiss it. No, we will say he is god, that he, why he is doing, I am a sada sida manusha. Manusha. In fact, Rama is referred as manusha some 30-40 times in Ramayana. Whenever Ravana talks about Rama, Rama uses the word manusha only. Manushya, 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 like that. That's a fact. Valmiki wanted to tell us that Rama lived like a human being. Follow closely how he reacted to situations in life and learn from it. Don't say he is a god. That is what it is. So here is one human character which is that expectation has built like anything. Dhruvam adhyeva mam raja yavaraje abhishekshati. 100% he is going to make me the Yuvaraja today itself. That is why he has come. It's a very, very important thing. That is why he has come. Like that he is saying. Look at the next sloka. The mood of Rama is showed even better in the next sloka. Look at what his next sloka is saying. Hanta. The word Hanta is used for good moods. Very good moods, you have to use words like Hanta. Okay? These are all words used only with that kind of a context. Hanta shigramito gatva drakshyami cha mahipatim sahatvam parivarena sukam aswaram asvacha. See, father has called. Anyway, today we have our Patabhisheka is there. Father, some small little clarifications are there. He has called. Correct? I will go. Quickly sort it out and come. We enjoy with your friends. I will come. Look at the mood. Second line he says, Tvam parivarena sukam aswa ramaswacha. It's a good mood. She is also in good mood. That young girl Sita is also in good mood. Both of them are in good mood that we are going to become the Yuvaraja and Yuvarani of this, you know, kingdom, no? So that is being said. Hanta, this is the word Hanta is used. Shikramito gatva drakshyami. I go quickly. He has that sense of this thing also. Rama also has that sense of I'll just come and come. So that we'll dress up properly, because there's a description of what kind of a vehicle is waiting for them. All those are there. I'm not getting into all those shlokas. Then you'll get a complete picture of what it is. Correct? Shikramitaha gatva mahipatim drakshyami cha. I'll go and see the father. Quickly I'll go. What is implied is I'll finish the formality and come back. In the meanwhile, we enjoy. Just spend a little time. We are all set anyway. See, if we have to go for a very important event, we are ready about half an hour back. What do? We relax. We do some nice things. Sit down. And that is the mood that you see here. Which means, Valmiki is portraying that Rama and Sita are in the thick of their expectations. Who said you should not have expectations in life? Everybody must have targets. Everybody must have expectations. Everybody must have goals. Of course, we must have all that. People are all misinterpreting many of our scriptures and Gita and all, saying it is not asking you to do nothing like that. The question is, what happens when your expectation is not met? This is where Indian scriptures score the point. What will happen if the expectations are not met? Expectations may not be met all the time. What will happen? Are you ready for it? That's what it is. Are you ready for it? That is the question that Indian scriptures answer. Ayodhyakanda puts it in grand detail. How do you react to the greatest disappointment you can have in your life? That's what Ayodhyakanda is going to show. So he says, you enjoy with your friends. Quickly I will go. Maybe small little some clarification is there. I will finish and then I will come. And there are a few shlokas. I again did not bring. Sita actually say blesses Rama like anything. He says, you will carry this, you will carry that, you will raise the thing of Brahma and all that. Please go and come back. Like that, she also shows her expectation. I didn't bring those shlokas in between 19 to 24. Sita is replying. I brought only one shloka. Sita is saying this. Purvam disham vajradaraha dakshinam patu teyamaha varuna paschimam asham daneshastuttaram disham. These are all become no meaning to us today. These sloka I brought only for that reason, to tell you that our notion of God have all become Pauranic gods. The gods that we worship today are Pauranic gods. Rama, Krishna, Saraswati, all Purana, Pauranic gods. Whereas nature was God, right? So what is Sita saying? Sita is saying, when you go on the east, you be protected by Indra. Vajradaraha. Indra carries the Vajra, na? Vajradaraha is Indra. On the south, you be protected by Yama, right? And on the west, you let you be protected by Varuna. And Dhanesha is actually Kubera. Last year we went to Bhutan. In Bhutan, in every temple, these four gods are there. We saw it. Last time we went to Bhutan, and then I remembered that when I read this. What I am saying is, we have lost sense of, this is how, if you read Indrakshi, Shivakaucha, you will find these kind of shlokas. We should know that the devas are not in a very, weird place. In fact, in Taittiriya Upanishad, in Manasa Ullasa, I think Taittiriya Upanishad, in Sureshwara Acharya's commentary, there's a complete description, when the description of the body in which presiding deity is in which part of the body. Lagunyasa, Prajanane Brahma Tishtatu, Padayor Vishnustishtatu, Hastayor Harastishtatu, Bahor Intrastishtatu, Jetare Agnistishtatu, Hridaye Sivastishtatu, Kante Vasavastishtantu, Vaktre Saraswati Tishtatu, Nasikayor Vayustishtatu, Nayaneyos Chandraditiyotishtetam, Karnayor Asinotishtetam, Lalate Rudrastishtantu, Murdinya Agni, I think. I have to tell very fast and I'm not used to telling, sir. Aditya, Murdinya Aditya Sishatu, Shirasa Mahadeva Sishatu, Sikayam Vamadeva Sishatu, Prishte Punagita Shatu, Purata Sholita Shatu, Pashvayo Shivasangarota Shtetam. Everything is like that. In Mahanyasa, as you said, Lagunyasa is just about 5 minutes. Mahanyasa is 1 hour. Complete description of how this is. Which presiding deity is in which part of our body. If you know, understand it, it is amazing to actually recite that. So, Mahamantra. These are all, we don't know. Today, these all become distant reality for us. She's saying like that. She's saying, let you be protected on four directions. We don't know all these. That's why I brought this shloka. Just to tell that you read any Vedic scripture, you'll find this. Mahanyasa, Lagunyasa, all these Pauranic shlokas. Indrakshi, Shiva Kavacha, any Kavacha you read, you'll find like this. These kinds of how the presiding deities are in Dasha, Dashadik Balakaha, all those. We don't even know the 10 directions, yes. Actually. Okay. So 17th sarga, it's a short sarga, 22 verses. First 6 verses are description of scene on the Rama's way to Dashada. It all continues. There's Valmiki is really building the whole tempo as a kavya. Okay. Again, people's conversation about on the street about Rama's coronation, Rama's arrival. That's, I am skipping this sarga because it is all adding to this seriousness of the problem at hand and the expectations that people have. That is what is being brought here. Finally, Rama reaches Dasharatha's place. This is a very interesting sarga. 41 verses. First of all, Rama is quite perplexed on seeing Dasharatha. He's stunned to see Dasharatha. First 9 shlokas, he is saying, what is happening here? I don't understand. I'll take 1 or 2 shlokas and show you what is Rama saying. Then he asks Kaikeyi, what is happening to Dasharatha? Why is it? What is happening to Dasharatha? And why is he, does he have grief or anger? What is happening? That question he asks, because Dasharatha is no mood to talk. He is not in a situation to talk. He is dumbfounded and he is weak. Last time we saw, no? Then Dasharatha Kaikeyi says, I will tell you, provided she thought, you know, this is the problem. We behave exactly the way we are. This, I don't know how many of you think about it. See, I once read a news. There's one school teacher, I mean, many school teachers do it. I don't know why they do it. They inflict maximum violence on the kids. How do they do it? Make them stand on the sun for 1 hour. I read one news. It comes every now and then, the same news. I read one news item. One 7th standard students in Vijayanagar or somewhere, scorching sun. Of course, if it happens in Chennai, it would have been fatal also. Bangalore scorching sun is all milder, so to speak. It's also now competing closely with Chennai anyway. So on a scorching sun, these boys were asked to stand on the hot ground without this thing for 1 hour. And one girl swooned. When I read it, for a couple of days, you know what was in my mind? In my mind was, in fact, this is the Dakshinamurti Stotram also, I have talked about it. You know, Vishwam Darpana Drishyamana Nagari Tulyam Nija Andargatam Pashin Atmanivaya Bhagiri Udbhutam. You know, Bhagiriva Udbhutam. You will only see yourself outside. The world you see outside are only you. So if you are a cruel person, you can only show cruelty to people. You don't know anything else. You can only do what you think you are. So you are a suspecting person, you'll suspect everybody. So what is Kaikeyi doing here? Kaikeyi is in things that the world is out, people in the world are all out to, because that is, she has been firmly established in that. In fact, I would give the benefit of doubt to mantra. Because Krishna says, avasham prakriteir vashat. I think this is the nature of Kaikeyi. It is Prakriti. Kaikeyi is Prakriti. Mantara only, you know, rubbed it off and brought it up. I don't think in 1/2 hour you can convince people. But in 1/2 hour, you can make people connect to your Prakriti. Please understand the difference between these two. So all these brainwashing and all, don't think. If you are brainwashed, that is your Prakriti. Please understand, that is your Prakriti. You cannot be brainwashed. Nobody can be brainwashed. There is no detergent available to wash the brain. It only means that it is my inherent nature. But you sort of connected that and then helped me bring out. So I will still give a benefit of doubt to mantra at the end of all that. So what is Kaikeyi do? Look at the shlokas 19 to 26. Kaikeyi says, she puts conditions. You father is not talking to you because he is unable to talk. And she talks about boons also, she doesn't say. She says, if only I am willing to tell you, provided after hearing favorable, not favorable, you have to agree to it. She extracts all those promises because she thinks that is her nature. She thinks Rama is also like that. That's all we can do. We can only, you know, that's why in Dakshinamurti he said, Vishwam Darpana Darshyamana Nari Tugaram. you know, it is like put a mirror and then you see the reflection of yourself. That is the world you see. That's why lochru is darshane. The dhatu lochru and lokru means darshane. That's why loka came. The world is what you see. It is only your lens. The world is what you see. If you think the world is out to cheat you, that means you are a person basically, person who always cheating. I am telling you, that is the meaning. If you think the world is out to cheat you, that means you are a person who actually cheats. That's why you also think others will be like that. So that's what she does. She extracted all those promises. He said, don't worry about all that. Please tell me, why are you putting all these prishtabhumika? Eta sarvam na avashyakam. Kimartam etadrusha prishtabhumika na avashyaka. Sakshat vikshayam vadatu. Please tell me what is the issue. Like that Rama is saying. Then upon receiving his assurance, Kaikeyi narrates in detail that she tells the whole thing. That your father, I mean, Valmiki uses some very nice words. Your father is trying to build a dam when the water has already flown. This is a word, this is a shloka. He says the water has already passed. He is trying to build a dam now. In other words, he has already promised and committed. What is the big point in trying to stop it now? She says, the water is already gone. Your father is trying to build a dam. That kind of prayogas are there. Shlokas are very nice. Setum nirmanam kartum ichati.
Rame tyuktva tu vachanam bashpa paryakulekshanah sashak anripati dinah nekshitum nabhibhashitum. Look at what is happening to Dasharatha. Dasharatha, Rama iti uktva, he just uttered the word Rama. That's all. Beyond that, he could not. Why? Because Bashpa Paryakulekshana, his eyes were filled with water, brimming with water. Right? Nripatihi, the king, Dinaha, he is at the lowest level of his mental stature. Right? Na ikshitum, na abhibhashitum shashaka. This Chakravarti just uttered the word Rama. He could not see him. He could not talk to him. His eyes are full of water. I mean, I am unable to say this. I go through a bit of this thing. Right? Roma Ashram Bhavati. Look at Dasharatha's situation that he is in. That's what he is saying. He is not able to see him. He is not able to speak. His eyes are full of... Who can tell Rama get lost? How is it possible? How is it ever possible? That is the situation here. Right? Remember the first three sargas of Ayodhyakanda. I spent a lot of time bringing all the good qualities of Rama at that time. And now we are here. So that is what it is. Na ikshitum, na abhibhashitum sashaka. He could not. Okay?
Tada purvam narapatehe drishtva rupam bhayavaham ramo pe bhayamapannah padaspruṣṭeva pannagam.
Rama was so afraid. Like what? Padaspruṣṭeva pannagam. Like a snake biting on your foot. On your path or on your way. Okay? On your foot. Not path, on your foot. Pada sprishteva pannagam. He was worried like that. Payavaham. Tat apurvam. That was unprecedented for him. He has never seen Dasharatha like that. Tad apurvam narapatehe drishtva. Rupam narapatehe apurvam drishtam drishtva. Rupam drishtva. Bayavaham apurvam narapatehe. All those will join. Same Dvitiya Bhakti, all of them will go together. Right? Bayavaham apurvam narapatehe rupam drishtva ramahapi bayamapannah. Rama also got fear. He has not seen his father like that. Ramahapi bayamapannah padaspruṣṭeva pannagam. As though he bitten or stepped or encountered a serpent on his path. Yeah?
Apras, அப்பிரசன்னமனாக்கின்னு சதாமாம் பிரதிவத்சலஹ விவர்ணவதனோ தீனஹ நஹிமாம் அபிபாஷதே.
Rama was very concerned, Dashrada is not talking to me. He has never been like that. He has never been like that until now. Why is he not talking to me? This is his great sense of concern. So he says, Aprasannamanaha. He is not a prasannamana. Right? Aprasannamanaha kim. Kimnu. Kinnu in sandhi. Kimnu. Sadamam prativasala. He was always, he had that vasalya towards me all the time. That is a Dasharatha, you know. He had that vasalya for me all the time. Right? But now he is vivarna vadana and dinaha. Nahimam abhibhashate. He looks very, this thing, he is not talking to me. So Rama was very perplexed. What is going on here? I don't know what is happening.
That's what he is seeing here. Then look at the next shloka. He is Valmiki every now and then, as I told you, will bring Lokaniti. When the story is going on, he will bring some Lokanyaya. Look at that. Next line, what he is saying, you see. It says, Shariro manaso vapi kanchidenam na bhadate santo pavo pitapova durlabam hi sadasukam. Durlabam hi sadasukam is a Lokanyaya. Right? But then he says, Shariraha santapahava manasaha abhitapahava. Right? Kaschitenam na badate. I hope. Na badate means it is not that it is not affecting him. I hope it is not, he is not affected either bodily or a grief or a stress in his mind. Rama is saying, Shariraha santapaha atava manasaha abhitapaha. That's why it says Shariro manaso, they are in the first line. Santapova abhitapova is in the second line. So you have to take one on one. Right? So, Shariraha santapahava, manaso abhitapahova, vapi kinchid enam na badate, enam dasharatam. Na badate, I hope it is not. Because then he says, durlabam hi sadasum. I can understand that you cannot be 24/7 in sukha. That's why Krishna said, matrasparshast kaunteya sitoshna sukha dukkataha, agamapayino anityaha. They are all agamapayinaha anityaha. Tam titikshaswa bharata. Sukha abhi bhavatu, dukkha abhi bhavatu. Ubo api anityo. Both are temporary. This is the wisdom of life. When sukha comes also, we should say it is temporary. When dukkha comes also, we should say temporary. But our mind is when sukha comes, even 1 year of sukha looks like 1 minute for us. And 1 minute of dukkha, we say as though it is like 1 hour, 1 year for us. These are all untrained ayuktaha, ayuktanam manasika vyaparaha. All these are things of ayuktas. Yuktas will never be like that. Ayuktas are like that. That's why he says, durlabhanghi sada sukham is a lokanyaya which he inserts in between the story. He says, understand, sukha will not be there all the time, which I can understand. But this looks a little unusual. So that lokanyaya is also put here, that agama paina, immediately I remembered that sloka, agama paina anityaha tam titikshaswa bharata. That's what here Valmiki is bringing that nyaya here. Aho dingnarhase devi vaktum mami drisham vachaha aham hi vachana dragnyaha pateyam api pavake bakshyeyam visham tikshnam manjeyam api charnave niyukto guruna pitra nrupena chahitena cha.
There are actually 6-7 shlokas. The greatness of a father. Rama really brings, so Valmiki brings so beautifully what pedestal we should put our father. So beautifully, I mean, in this case it happens to be father. It is actually Pitarao. It is not father. It is both. But in the context it happens to be Dasharatha. So don't misunderstand this. It is the pedestal we have to put our, that's why in Taittiriya Upanishad it said, Matra Devo Bhava, Pitra Devo Bhava, then only Acharya Devo Bhava, then Atithi Devo Bhava. Because the first introduction of life and our marga to our, not only world,
our route to evolution is shown only by the mother first, because the child spends the maximum time of the first 5 to 6 years only with the mother, not with the father. Father will come for half an hour. That's why Matridevo Bhava. It is the mother who first shows what is life and what you have to achieve. When the child grows into an adulthood, that's when the father comes and spends a lot of time. And there is another learning which happens for the child from the father. That's why father comes second in the line. Then the acharya comes, because the first lessons are at home. On any day, the first lessons are with the parent. In today's society, if the parents refuse to teach and say that Aya Devo Bhava, good luck for the children. Instead of Matridevo and Pitridevo, if you want to say Aya Devo Bhava, good luck for you. That's not what it is. I think the child's greatest lessons and evolution and everything is possible only in the first 10 years of its life, where maximum time initially is spent by the mother, then by jointly by both of them. That is what is so. Although here it is saying father, but see what he is saying. First of all, he says, Aho dik, na arhase devi vaktum maam idrisham. Why are you extracting all these promises from me? Like, you should not have spoken like this. Idrisham vaktum na arhe. Right? It's not at all required. There is no need for it. That's why the dik is a foolish thing. Whenever, you know, something foolish happens, dik. Dik dikshatrabalam visa. When Vishwamitra said, he said, when he saw Vasishtha's hermitage and all that, tejobalam brahmabalam, dik dikshatrabalam, tejobalam brahmabalam, we saw that in Balakanda. So dik is used when there is an act of foolishness. Why did you do this? The Sanskrit word is dik. Aho. Aho is also, you know, ascharya. Why are you doing it? You need not have asked all these, extract all these so-called, promises before telling what needs to be told. Aho dik narhase devi vaktum maam idrisham vasaha. You don't have to speak like this. Why? Aham hi vachana rajnyaha vachanat. Right? He says, Pateyam api pavake. He asked me to jump in the fire. I'll jump. Father says, I'll jump. Pavake pateyam. Pateyam iti pavake. Okay? Bhaksheyam tikshnam visham. This biting, poison. If father asks me to take, I'll take. Correct? Then he says, Manjeyam api cha arnave. He asked me to get immersed into the deepest ocean, I will. Just go and get drowned into the ocean. He says, go and get drowned in the ocean, I will. Okay? Why? I am Guruna Niyukta Pitra, Guruna Niyukta Han Rupena Cha Hitena Cha. Because I have this firm belief. Look at the kind of adjectives he is using. Guru, Nripa, Pita, then Hitena Cha. Right? There is this unshaking belief that what my parents say is only for my good. This is a big question now in the name of modernity. They have respect for parents, but there seems to be a boundary there. I don't know how we sort of got into this methodology. They have respect, but that seems to be working on a certain envelope. This is boundaryless. It is Shraddha. This is called Shraddha. Shraddha is your ability to not use your intellectual faculty, but know that, you know, what he's told is for my good, without any second thinking. So he gives there are 5-6 shlokas. I think picked 1 or 2 shlokas. Very highly he talks about why you don't have to do all these. It's all not required. You could have simply told me and that's it. Very simple. Then starts Rama, really. The rest, this 19th chapter is a great, showing the great character called Rama. Look at some of the important things. Tadbru hivachanam devi ragyo yadabhi kankshitam karishye pratijane cha ramo dvirnabhi bhashate. Very, very important things are coming here.
Father is not able to tell, doesn't matter, but he desired something. No, you tell. You just tell me. Rajnyah yat abhikankshitam tat vachanam bruhi, hey Devi. You tell me. Father doesn't have to tell. He is here. You tell me. Right? Karishe, I will do. Pratijane, please be known. Please know. Know what? Know what is Rama? Rama dvihi na abhibhashate. Rama will not do to say two things, which means he will not go back on his word. Do something else. I will not go back on my word. That's the first strength of character he is showing. He is not. He doesn't even know what is going to be told. Boom, sir, he heard already. He said, no, it's coming later. Because I showed you in the, it's coming. He said, you tell. Ramaha dvir nabibhashate. This is the personification of this great character called Rama. There's nothing in the dictionary of Rama where I say something. Moment you say, oh, in this case, probably I will not. That's not there. It is simply not. I mean, this is the strength of character. This is, if you ask what is strength of character, this is called strength of character. Not have temptations and put ifs and buts and riders and all that. This is called strength of character. That's what he says. Then what does he say? He says, iti vatasyam parush, iti vatasyam parusham vadantyam na chaiva rama pravivesha shokam pravivyate chapi mahanubhavah rajatu putra vyasanabhitaptah. This again shows another great character of Rama. What is it saying? Iti eva tasyam parusham vadantyam. She is telling all hard things. Kaikeyi is really blasting things which are not good here. I am not, this is the last that I will want to hear when I am the brink of getting, my coronation done. He is hearing things. Very harsh words. So, tasyam parusham vadantyam chaiva ramaha na pravivesha shokam. This is what it is. Na pravivesha shokam. This is called titiksha. This is called titiksha. Sahanam sarva dukkanam apratikara purvakam. Chinta vilaparahitam. Sa titiksha vidiyate titikshate whatever. That is what it is. No vilapanam. Momentarily it comes but it goes. He rose to the highest, high ground of his character. So what did he say? He said, Ramaha na pravivesha shokam. This idea did not introduce grief in him. Momentarily he had emotions, but it did not introduce grief in him. This is another strength of character. This is called character. When tough things happen to you, please show your temperament here. Don't show, you say, I am very great when everything is going well. When people shout at you, when people do things which is, putting you in a very bad situation, at that time you show. Let us measure you on that, at that situation. So that is what it is. And Rama is showing that. He's saying no. Apuryamanam achalapratishtam samudramapaha pravishanti yatvat. He is like that ocean which is full of water. Samudrameva gambiram. It's what he uses. Valmiki. Okay. But what was happening for the Raja? He says, Putra Vyasana Abhitaptaha. There is a great danger happening to this Putra which is scorching him. On the other side, the father is there. The father is greatly, destroyed by the great calamity in a very unfair manner happening to the son. But the son did not have an iota of grief in him. This is the character of Rama. Then comes the most important sarga in Ayodhyakanda, where the full-blown character of Rama you will see. Ideally, I should have actually spent all the 40 shlokas. But then I simply took a few. I couldn't know which shloka to drop and which shloka to take. I took some set of some, maybe 20 shlokas or 15 shlokas. Quickly, I will think. Beautifully, it comes out how this character called Rama had faced that situation. We'll straight go into it because most of the shlokas we are going to see.
tada priyama mitragnah vachanam maranopamam shrutva nanivyayate ramah kaikeyim cheda bravit tat apriyam amitragnah vachanam maranopamam. The word that the sent, the message he got from Kaikeyi is maranopamam. It's as good as saying, go and die. It's like that, no? It is at such level, no? Right? Amitragnaha, who is Rama, right? Apriyam maranopamam vachanam shutva na vivyayate. It did not even shake him a bit. Right? Ramaha kaikeyim cha idam abravit. He said thus. You have to read the remaining 39 shlokas. Beautiful shlokas. The complete strength of character of Rama you will see in this sarga actually. Okay? I'm going to the fourth shloka. From the first shloka, 2-3 I'm skipping. I'm going to the fourth shloka. Manyur nachatvaya karyo devi bhumi tava gratah yasyami bhava suprita vanam chira jatadharah. So what is he saying? Tvaya karyah, right? He says, first of all he says that Suprita Bhava, first you be happy. Why you have to be happy? Because Yasyami, Vanam, Chira, Jatadaraha, exactly the way you want I will do. First you rest us peace. You seem to be very, very agitated. Right? Don't have this anger. Nothing is required. What has happened? He Trinamiva, he just dismissed. She thought it is going to be a big thing and Dasharatha that even bigger. What did he say? First I'll tell you I'm going. Settle first. Right? Toya karye devi brumi tava agra. So, you know, I whatever has to be done going forward, I will do all that. Whatever activities have to be done, you go ahead and do. Don't worry, I will go. Right? Tava agrataha vina karyaha. Let it all, you know, this thing, don't worry, I will do. Nothing to worry. First, he assures her peace. This is Rama's strength. Rama, you know, abayam sarva papebhya, you know, datami etat vratam. When he, Vibhishana came, there was a big conversation in Yudhakanda in some 7th sarga, 8th sarga, 15th sarga, something, I don't remember, where everybody argued, don't let him in. He says, that the character of Rama, like he says, Ramo dvir abhina bibhashate, like that he says, dadami etad mama vratam, abayam sarva bhutebhyaha, dadami etad vratam mama. He said, this is my very purpose of life. Somebody says, abaya, I will give. Let it be any risk. If somebody says, abaya, I will give. There comes another character in Yudhakanda, you will see it. Very nicely it will come. When Vibhishana, Saranagati happens, that time, Rama says, this is what Rama is, please know. Like that, here also, he first says, because Rama has abhayahasta. Nobody has to have fear. Kaikeyi has to have no sense of fear. Dasharatha has to have no sense of unnecessary fear. That is the character called Rama. That's what he says.
Ali kammanasam tvekam hridayam dahativame swayam yannahamam raja bharatasya abhishechanam.
Look at what he's saying. There is something which bothers me a lot. What bothers me a lot? Father did not tell me. He could have told me about Bharata's Abhishechana. That's what he says. He says, Swayam Raja Mam Na Aha. He didn't tell me. That is what is bothering me. Fact that I am going to the forest is not bothering me. The fact that Father did not tell me. Right? See, I remember one episode of Kanchi Paramacharya. There was one episode that happened and you know, to cut the story, instead of the episode, I tell you, at the end of the episode, Paramacharya said, it merely showed that my tapas is not enough. He did not put the blame on a few things that happened. He said, it merely shows that my tapas is still not enough. Here, what it is implied is, it merely shows I have not instilled that much confidence in my father. Looks like father did not get that unshaking confidence that Rama will take anything. That is why he is coming with this shloka. That is why he is coming with this particular angle. So he is saying, Hridayam ekam, alikam manasam tu ekam, hridayam dahativame. This is, you know, really bothering me. And what is bothering me? Father did not take the courage and confidence to tell me, because probably he thought, I don't know what is going on here. I have not made myself even more worthy of what I ought to be. That is what is coming through this shloka. This is what Rama says there. Then he says, Aham hisitam rajyam cha pranan nishtan dhanani cha krashto bratre swayam dadyam barataya prachoditaha. Barataya, he says, barataya aprachoditaha, without asking. For the sake of Bharata, aprachoditaha. Now there is a prachodanam which is happening. You are coming and you are asking and all that. Without all of them, what will I give? I will give Sita. I will give the kingdom. I will give my life. I will give my entire, you know, wealth. I will give up everything. Give means give up. I will give up everything. I am willing to give up anything. Krashtaha. Happily, for the sake of my brother, you want to give up everything, I will give up. I will give up everything. Right? Bharataya apre prachoditaha. Without asking, I am capable of doing. I don't know why we have to go through all these chakra. These were all not required in the first place. So Rama's worry at that point in time, Valmiki brings Rama as not a person who got disappointed, my expectations are gone, I am crestfallen, not like that. He's saying, my standards are lower than what I myself thought. Look at that character. He says, my standards are lower than what I thought. That is the concern he has. These shlokas are bringing that.
Evam bhavatu yasyanti duta shigra vrajair hayaihi bharatam matula kulat upayavartayitum naraha.
Evam bhavatu, let it be so. This issue is settled. Evam bhavatu, right? Go and get immediately, you send dutaha shigra javaihi hayaihi, fast running horses. Send 100 horsepower, right? Send and dutaha to where? Matula kulat. He is leveling the uncle's, maternal uncle's place. No. Send people and bring him immediately. He wants not an iota of doubt that Kaikeyi must have. He says, right now, you do it. Done. Whole thing is finished. Get him immediately. That's what. See how the character is shining now. From a position of huge hope and expectation, I will also show you when he goes and meets Sita, you have to see that scene. We will see that. 23rd Sarga or something, we will have to see. 19th Sarga, no? 23rd Sarga, I think. You should see what happens when he goes and sees Sita. It's a very, very touchy situation. That's why Rama is a human character. It talks about the emotions of human beings, yet it shows that there is a limit to which you can raise.
Tavatvaham kshamam manye notsukasya vilambanam rama tasmat ita shigram vanantvam gantum arhasi.
What is going on here? Even after all that, what is Kaikeyi saying? Right? Tu, he says, na utsukasya. See, you are not interested. Right? Vilambanam kshamam na manye. It is not appropriate to delay any further. Anyway, you are not interested. You are not interested. So delay is not a good thing. Right? This is Kaikeyi's mind. Look at Kaikeyi's mind. Right? It's all madness, and as I told you, it's madness and desperation. Okay?
Rama, tasmate, itaha, shigram tom gantum arasi. Get out fast. Take a Uber, something, quickly order for a Uber and go. Uber is not there, ask for Ola, immediately go. Ola auto at least, something like that. Go immediately. That's a level of desperation that she is exhibiting here. So look at this character and that character. Side by side, Valmiki is bringing that. Yavat tvam navanam yataha purat asmat abitvaran pita tavanna naramaha snasyate bokshyate pivashi. Putting lies after lies and lies, telling all kinds of things to get him out of the way very fast. He's saying, until you go, father is not going to take bath and eat. That's what he's saying. She's saying, Yavat tvam vanam na yataha purat asmat abitvaran. Until you quickly get out of this place, tavat, until then, pita, hey Rama, right? Nasnasyate, bokshate piva. He will not take bath and he will not eat also. So don't starve your father. What pressure tactics, what low level this lady is operating from, and what heights of character the other character is. There's a world of difference. You can't bridge these two. Even modern technology cannot find a bridge for putting these two ends together. That is how Valmiki is showing both the characters side by side.
Nahamartha paro devi lokamavastu mutsuhe viddimam rishi bistulyam kevalam dharma mastitam.
Another exhibition of the character of Rama. What is he saying? Viddi, please understand, viddimam, understand me to be what? Rishi tulyam. I am like a rishi. Don't worry, I am like a rishi. Kevalam dharma mastitam. I am established only in dharma and dharma alone, nothing else. Please understand that. Why are you showing this desperation? That is what it is. He says, Viddi mam rishibhi tulyam. I am like rishis. Kevalam dharma mastitam. I am established only in dharma, nothing else. There is nothing which can shake me. That's what Rama is saying in reply. Right? Aham na aham artha paraha, right? Lokam lokam avastum utsuke. In fact, I have no desire to live also. I mean, I am beyond all these riches and this and wealth and these living in the world are all very low level items. I am Rishibhistulya. Don't worry, all these will not shake me. That's why I said, Apuryamanam achala pratishtam samudram apaha pravishan tadvat, Akama Kami, what Krishna says in second chapter. That is a character which is being portrayed here, exhibited in full measure in this sarga. That's what Rama says in return. Then he says,
Nahyato dharma charanam kinchidasti mahattaram yata pitiru sisrusha tasyava vachana kriya.
Very powerful statements. Every sloka brings the best of the character called Rama.
Nahi itaha dharmacharanam kinchidasti mahataram.
For me, there is nothing better or greater than going on the path of dharma. There is nothing else which will excite me. That is what I am. Okay?
Yata pitara susrusha. Example is giving. Pitara susrusha is dharmacharanam for me. Pitara susrusha vachana kriya.
What my father said. Already, yes, there are some shlokas. I showed you only two shlokas. He said, whatever father says and doing service to the father is an element of my dharma. I will not waver a little bit here and there. So the character of Rama is showing all it in full measure through these shlokas. Whole chapter is like that. I don't know which shloka to take and which shloka to leave. Simply, I took a few shlokas.
Nanu nammai kaikeyi kinchida kinchidasham sase gunam yadrajanam avochastvam mameshwaratarasati.
It's a very, very heavy heart shloka from Rama. You know what is Rama saying here? He's saying,
na nunam mayi kaikeyi kinchit asham sase gunam.
Kaikeyi, you never saw any good guna in me. You did not see me worthy of anything.
there is an element of sadness coming out in this shloka. He's saying, you did not see any guna in it, in me. And why is he saying that? He says, Mama Ishwaratara Sati. You had all the control on me. You need not have done all this drama. You would have simply called me and said, Rama, you go. Go to the forest. I want Bharata to rule the kingdom. You created so much havoc on the father. Did this, did that. Why did you do? Because you thought I am not worth the assault. That's what the first line is saying. Nanunam mayi kaikeyi kinchid ashamsase gunam. You did not see any worthy character in me. Right? That is why you made father speechless. Yet rajanam avachotaha tum. You took charge of the whole thing. You need not have done all that. You yourself had a Ishwaratara on me. You could have exercised lordship in me, but you did not see no guna means you are so fearful of me. You thought I am like you, all bad gunas. So you have to play out so many complicated games to come here. This is an element of sadness with which Rama say, you need not have done all this. You could have simply told me, whole thing is over. That's what is coming through this shloka.
Bharata palayet rajyam susruṣe cha pituryata tata bhavatya kartavyam sahi dharma sanatanaha.
This character, for a moment it may bring it emotion, but the next moment it will go to the best of its character. That is how you will see in Ayodhyakanda throat. So now what he is saying, he has regained his heights of his character. He says, all that is fine. Make sure that Bharata rules properly, takes care of the father. That is your responsibility. Because you created all this, make sure these two things happen. He now has come back to his state. So he says, Bharataha palayet rajyam. Susrushesha pituhu yata. Let him do these two. Let him take care of the kingdom, do service to the father. Right? That is your kartavya. At least you ensure that this is taken care. He tells to Kaikeyi, because you had no faith in me, that's all old story. At least you have faith in your son and do make sure things are all right. That is what he is saying here.
Abhishechanikam bhandam kritvarama pradakshinam shanair jagama sapekshah drishtim tatra vichalayan.
Rama is a human being, please understand. When he went out of that place, his eye was on all those big vessels in which the water has been placed for Abhishecha. Because he is a human being, please understand. That's what Valmiki is saying here. He is saying, Sapekshaha Drishtim, Tatra Vichalayan. It went there. Because 2 minutes back, he thought he is going to be, in 2 minutes, the world has changed. So that emotion he should have, no? That's why Rama is portrayed as a human being. These shlokas are saying that he also has emotions. Who said he doesn't have emotion? He has emotion. So that's what the shloka is saying. He's saying, Abhishechanikam bandam kritva Rama pradakshinam. When he went around, circumambulated all those vivida nadyaha, tirtaha, tatra, sannivesaha abhavan. So there he has went and then he did. But when he went, his eye was there. That shows that he is a human being. It has also affected him. That momentary things we all must have in life. But Valmiki says, don't get too much stuck with that. That is a lesson that Rama beautifully displays in Ayodhya Kanda.
Navanam gantukamasya tyajatascha vasundharam sarva lokatigasyeva lakshyate chitta vikriya. The na chitta, na lakshyate chitta vikriya, you have to take it out. There's again a lokanyaya here. You know what is Valmiki saying here? He's saying, a person who is ready to go to the forest, manam gantukasya, gantukamasya, the one who is very evenly, he has taken it with folded hands, whatever you have given. What is that? Manam gantukamasya, vasundaram tyajatascha. He has given up his rights and ownership to this kingdom. He was ready for both. Sarva loka atigasyeva. He is beyond all the normal things of worldly affairs.
If a person is like that, now
this is where the Lokanyaya is coming now. Now Valmiki is saying, if a person can be like this, then he says, Nalakshyate Chitta Vikriya, his mind will not do this circus. You're getting upset. You are saying the whole world, Rama could have done all that. I have been a very nice person. I did no harm to anyone. Why did it happen to me? Why people are all scheming against me? Why all these bad things? That is Chitta Vikriya. He says, Nalakshyate Chitta Vikriya. So this is again the character of Rama beautifully showing up. He readily gave up his entitlement of the kingdom. He readily and gladly was willing to go to the forest. By these two acts, he is clearly showing, I am sarvaloka, you know, atigataha. I am beyond this worldly affairs. If a person can be like that, this is called detached attachment. This is exactly called detached attachment. Rama had attachment to the kingdom. Rama had attachment to the act of Pattabhisheka, but it was a detached Padmapatra Ivambasi. That is a better way to say. It's like a water on a lotus leaf. If we develop a detached attachment to life, if you don't develop the sense of entitlement, if you develop a sense of aparigraha and tyaga, for such a person, na lakshyate chitta vikriya. That is the Lokanyaya there. Nothing will happen. Such a person's mind will never be disturbed. Na lakshyate chitta vikriya. For such a person, nothing will happen. That's the Lokanyaya that Valmiki is bringing here. That Brahma was like that. He could be sarvaloka atigataha. He could reach that level. His mind will never be disturbed.
Our mind is disturbed.
Pravishyaveshmati brisham mudanvitam samikshyatam charta vipattimagatam nachaiva ramotra jagama vikriyam suhajanasyatma vipatti shankaya. Beautiful shloka. It's a beautiful shloka. You know, Rama, he is now come back to the palace. He is coming back to his. Then he says, there are so many people who are my well-wishers. I don't want to, you know, create trouble for them. So he was very composed. He said, Sukhrut janasya atma vipatti shankaya. He is something that happened to him will create an atma vipatti for his Sukhrut, his friends. That shankaya, because of the doubt and the fear, he did not show anything. He was a very composed person. Even such a big thing happened to him, he was very composed. How do you handle situation? Leadership. How do you handle situations in life? And who can have a much worse situation than what is being described here? This is heights of character and leadership. Right? He says, Pravishya Veshma Atibrisham Mudanvitam. It is all happiness. Now he is getting into the palace, which is full of rejoicing. Samikshya, samyak ikshya. Oh, people are all in great moods. Let us, if I say this is what it is, it's all gloomy. It is not gloomy. Now they will resort to violence. They will take a stone and throw and destroy the public property. We have a different samskara now, different samskriti now. But, right, he says, Artha vipattam agatam tam. If this wrong thing that has happened, if they get to know all that, right? Jagama vikriyam, na vikriyam, na jagama vikriyam. No, he did not show his emotions. He, because he realized that you should not do this. It will create a greater commotion. So what a responsibility, you see. What a responsibility he is demonstrating here by this act. By doing this. Again, this is a character that we need to emulate. This is why Rama, Rama and Rama. Everywhere Rama, Rama and Rama. Because this is the personification of perfection of character possible. One dimension we see here. Aranyakanda will another dimension. Sudarakanda will another dimension. Yudhakanda will see another dimension. Balakanda will see another dimension of Rama. So with that, this particular sarga ends. Beautiful sarga, 19th sarga has to be read. I have used some 20 shlokas out of 40. 18 and 19, if you, in fact, that 9 to 19
It's all heavily loaded. Very, the story is very, very deep, and lessons are very deep. There's enormous lessons that we can learn from life. That is the greatness of Ayodhyakanda. So with that, we will stop this 19th Sarga and the class for today. Swasti prajabhya paripalayantam nyayena margena mahim mahishah ko brahmanebhyo shubhamastu nityam loka samasta sukino bhavantu kale varshatu parjanyah prithivi sasya shalini deshoyam kshobarahitah brahmana santu nirbhayah aputra putrinasantu pautrinah adhana sadhana santu jivantu sharadam shatam shrinvan ramayanam bhaktya yappadam padame bhava sayati brahmanasthanam brahmana pujyate sada harihi om. So the rest of Ayodhyakanda, you will see the character of Rama beautifully portrayed from now on. How he and Sita handled what was befalling on them, up to the great conversation between Bharata and Rama, which is the culmination of this Ayodhyakanda. Wonderful shlokas, wonderful moment of lessons of life, all that we will see in Ayodhyakanda. Okay, we'll stop here. Next class, I will not have. And probably the week, I had 4-5 continuous, so 2 breaks now, I think. I need to travel and...